Speaker is Mr. P.R. Bagel from Semilac. He is going to talk on his experiences on certification of manned aircraft Tejas. The relevance to this program is that today one of the main topics on UAV is how to certify the UAVs to fly in national airspace. So we have a lot to relate the practices followed in manned aircraft to unmanned aircraft. And I think it will be a very enlightening experience for us to hear from him how he went about certifying Tejas. Mr. Bagel, he is an electronics engineer from Jabalpur University, and almost all his career he has been with Semilac, working on certification of Russian aircraft systems. And presently, he has been with Semilac Bangalore as director of RCMA aircraft, and working on the certification of Tejas. And recently, he has been one of the leading members of the team which conferred the IOC. So we have a lot to hear from him. Mr. Bagel.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, very good morning to you. Recently, the New Year gift you must have seen, 10th January 2011, the initial operation clearance of LCA is given by Semilac. This is a very dream which has come true in 2011. And how we have followed the journey for certification towards induction of the aircraft in the services. So this half an hour, I will take you with me in a small journey to make you understand what is the certification process followed for LCA program. Before I take you to that journey, before boarding the bus, let me introduce the organization so that you can understand what is the importance of the certificate, importance of the certification. For the certification in India, there's an organization called Semilac, Center for Military Airworthiness and Certification. We have been given some responsibilities and some important role to discharge our duties toward the safe airworthiness support to the Indian Air Force. Semilac gives the design clearance and certification to the indigenous aircraft. It provides continued airworthiness support to the indigenous licensed and bought out aircraft, and gives the clearance to the modification evolved on the aircraft throughout its life and major upgrades of the aircraft and life extension. The type approval activity is very important activity for the systems and the aircraft and LRUs, raw materials and the consumables. We also participate during the investigations of the aircraft accident and incident. From time to time, Semilac issues the directives wherever there is a deviation or the misinterpretation of the airworthiness, then Semilac issues the directives. We are also involved in the process certification of some refineries which are producing the aviation fuel lubricants. And finally, we also give the approval to the design houses and the test houses based on their competency towards the aeronautics. Now you see the spectrum of activities is very, spectrum is very, very large. I may not read all the complete activities, but in short, just I'll tell you the major activities, avionics design, where the complete certification process is involved, then continued airworthiness support for license and bought out aircraft, and airworthiness assurance in license manufacturing aircraft. We also certify the system developed abroad and the evaluation of the indigenized system. And recently, we are involved in the design clearance of the unmanned air vehicle. As an organization, Semilac is headed by our chief executive, Airworthiness, Dr. K. Tamilmani. As this Semilac is under scientific advisor to Raksha Mantri. Basically, There are three technical group works in Similac under the various group like aircraft group, propulsion group, and system group. These groups are also followed by the regional center for military airworthiness at various places. Under aircraft group, there is one RCMA aircraft in Bangalore, helicopter in Bangalore, and various RCMAs at Nasik, Kanpur, and Chandigarh. Under propulsion group, the RCMA engine is in Bangalore and Koraput, then RCMA materials in Hyderabad, and foundry and forge at Bangalore. System group, RCMAs are Lucknow, Hyderabad, Korba, air armament at Pune, and missile group in Hyderabad. There are other groups which are also working in the Similac. Now you see the Similac, how its evaluation is taken place. It has born in 1958, and it has come to the 50 plus year journey with the establishment of the various technical offices. Now in 1995, it was converted to the Similac, and all the RTOs, Resident Technical Offices, were known as Regional Center for Military Airworthiness. And this is the geographical location of the various RCMAs within the country. Now you see the canvas of our activities. It has started in 1958 with the basic jet trainer, Kiran and Krishak. Now you see in this envelope, now we are here, the large spectrum of the activities, the LCA, avionics, hawk, and various new technologies, EW, UAV, IJT. This is our, with our experience, the activity is going to increase and increase. Now, let me tell you the definition of the airworthiness and certification. Direct definition of airworthiness, it is very difficult to explain, but implied definition, simply I can say, to say fitness to fly. It ensures the continued capability of the aircraft for the performance and the fulfilled mission requirement throughout its specified life under the prevailing environment with acceptable level of safety. And the certification, this is a process which provides the possibility of making certain that any aircraft, whether civil or military, with the acceptable level of safety and future utilization within the defined flight load spectrum within a specified period. This is a very small certification methodology. I need not to go in detail. This is a methodology we followed for the development program and upgrade program by capturing the requirement from the three services and converting it to the technical specification, and with the design evaluation superimposed with the compliance of safety requirement, the aircraft is clear for the flight testing, and with the data reduction and analysis and the document for the complete type record, this is becomes the basis of the certification. Now coming to the LCA, where we are looking for the future. The LCA technologies are various modern technologies has been used. I need not to go in the detail, like the advanced material composite to reduce the weight, increase the life, reduce signature, the dual redundancy in the avionics system, 00 ejection seat, multimode radar as an advanced sensor, the glass cockpit to reduce the pilot workload, and the quadrilateral digital flight control system, four channels, stealth technology, and the general system. So whereas modern technologies have been followed for the LCA, and it was tough to certify those technologies also. So give the certificate. Now we have followed the LCA certification. For the LCA certification, we have made a three segment for the certification. The first is design evaluation or analysis of the design, what is going to be designed for the to meet the requirement of Indian Air Force for LCA specification. Then induct the system for the testing, for ground and flight testing both. And finally comes to the certification. It is an analysis of all the results. through design evaluation, ground and flight testing, and making the documentation proper so that the certification is given. Under the design evaluation, we have followed for the concurrent approach to address the safety, reliability, and performance at three levels, LRU level, system level, and the aircraft level. We also imbibe the military standards during the design and the testing programs, and we have frozen the design through the PDR and CDR. This is the preliminary design review and the critical design review, and which is followed by the various other program reviews, which I will let you know a little later. Under the ground testing, this enables the verification and validation of the design intent at both system level and the aircraft level. The certification agency is to coordinate the technical specification test facility also and approve the test cases matrix and acceptance test procedure and followed by the test results. Ground testing also, you follow at the system level. You see the what is the comprehensive testing is planned for the LCA, all the system. You see here the EMI, EMC, the R-1. This is a basically complete flight control system is simulated on the ground, and all the actuators and the flight control system is simulated on the ground before clearing for the aircraft. Like this with the avionics rig, the complete architecture of the avionics is totally evaluated on the ground before integrating on the aircraft. So like this, there are various facilities our designers have created to certify the system before porting on the aircraft. Under structural testing, we have followed the mast, MAFT, and SCT, the main airframe structural testing, main airframe fatigue testing, and the structural coupling test. The very huge infrastructure is made for the structural testing of the LCA aircraft. Now come to the flight testing. The aim of flight testing is to validate the design, assessing the individual system performance and the aircraft performance, and any shortcomings is there needs to fine-tune the design and achieve the robustness through the snag rectification, which have been covered under the various prototype flights. And finally, achieve the confidence for the induction of the aircraft in the services. In case of LCA, the general flight testing has been done in Bangalore, but the environmental flight testing has been done at various places for hot weather tries at Nagpur, two phases. The temperature was 44 degrees centigrade, and the cold weather and high altitude trials has been done at Leh with minus 25 degree temperature. Sea level trials has been done at Arkunam, Goa, and Jamnagar. This testing is yet to be undertaken, rain test. For any aircraft, when it is ready for the flight, the certificate Similac has to issue the flight clearance note. First flight is taken off with this note, which covers the standard of the preparation of the aircraft, basis of the clearance, operating limitation to be followed, system limitations are there in the aircraft, and the what are the envelope it is to be followed during flying, and the condition of the release. In LCA program, as of now, there are 11 prototypes have been designed and flying in the sky with the logging on the, as on yesterday, 1551 successful flight with 920 hours logged in. Recently, this is the LSP-5 aircraft, which is the IOC version of the aircraft. We started from 4th January 2001, and we have given IOC in 10th January 2011, the 10-year journey of the 11th prototype aircraft flown in the sky with 1551 successful flight. We have achieved almost all the targets what we have set. For the speed, 1350 kilometer, Mach number 1.6, altitude 15 kilometer, angle of attack 22 degree, and G load 6. As I told you, we had the concurrent approach, but there was a very, very strong monitoring was required. At the various level, the monitoring has been done. The quarterly review, the empowerment committee under the heading of Chief of Air Staff at Air Headquarters, he has monitored the complete program every quarter with the, all the organization, what is the progress of the air, this development program. And it is introduced the maintenance of the, when aircraft was maturing towards the induction, the maintenance issues are also to be addressed, and the air officer maintenance at Air Headquarter, he has started taking the quarterly review. And to have the continuous monitoring monthly level, Deputy Chief of the Air Staff, he has started taking the monthly review at ADA. And there is a daily review. There is no what is a weekly review, but daily some review is there. Like I tell you, PCT, Program Coordination Team, this is undertaken by Program Director, LCA, every Monday. And FDPR, Flight Development Program Review, every Wednesday. This is converted, then the certification is added to the FDPR, has become the Design Development Certification Review. Then further now, after the certification process is almost over for IOC, then comes to the production and the quality of the series production aircraft. Now it has become design, production, and quality review. We had the FTRG, flight test requirement generation and certification to capture what are the flight test points to be followed during the flight test program. And there is a technical control group to control the complete technical activities on Friday. And the flight control system, every Tuesday, it has a performance verification committee. In all the these reviews, the certification agency has played very, very vital role to resolve all the issues towards the certification. Beyond that, there are the program reviews. When the aircraft has to take off and go to the sky first time, the first flight, this has to undergo various reviews. And the final review is taken as a flight readiness review board under the chairmanship of C. Semilac. He has to take the stock of each and every activities applicable to that platform. Then only the FCN is given for the first flight. It's a very, very important first flight every aircraft has followed. SRV is also there when the integration of the major armament system has been taken place on the aircraft, like missile, bomb, drop tank. That time we need to see the safety of the aircraft, which is also controlled by Chief Executive Semilac through the Safety Review Board. When last year, somewhere in January or February, when a defense minister has told now he needs the LCA for the services. And it is was going towards the maturity. Then our chief executive has taken a lead role now to certify the aircraft. He has assigned this task to our team, Regional Center for Military and RCMA, to make the roadmap for the certification. Our team, on 31st May, we have released one document which is the route to certification document. What are the roadmap? What is the route to be followed for the certification? The baseline we have taken from the ASR, Air Staff Requirement, which was released in 1985. We have captured all the requirements from the ASR and we have made the certification requirement towards the IOC. What we did, we have taken the stock of all the tasks already completed at during the May 2010. And we have seen what are the tasks pending needs to be completed for the IOC. And they were then various categories, the design analysis, ground testing, and flight testing requirement. Not only this testing, we need to address the many other aspects of the certification, like the qualification of the LRU, line replaceable unit, and the system certification specification, the compliance of the military standards, compliance of the air staff requirements, store configuration, and the flight demonstration. And finally, we need to make the complete document needs to be followed for the complete throughout the life of the aircraft. Now I'll come to the LRUs, line replaceable unit. You will surprise there are 346 LRUs are installed on this very small aircraft. Out of these 346, 178 LRUs are indigenously developed within the country, and 160 LRUs are bought out from the foreign sources. We have followed these are the two route we have followed for the LRU certification. Here we started this qualification because full qualification of the system takes very long time. What we did, followed the SOFT concept, safety of flight test. We have to take the very small segment of the full qualification testing and allow the system to fly for the limited life. Then we go for the limited qualification and finally full qualification test, because it is a long process involved. Whereas the bought out item, we have taken sometimes on analogy basis, flying already on other platform, and if there is requirement of a delta qualification, the incremental qualification, which may meet our LCA requirement, for which we have made very detailed checklist to qualify the bought out item. This is the certification of the bought out item. We have captured the technical specifications of the LRUs and country of origin, what is the airworthiness certificate given. We have seen the results of the qualification test undertaken by the OEM, original and equipment manufacturer, and we need to see the in-flight performance and during the various conditions and flight envelope. We have also seen the estimated MTBF quoted by OEM and reliability prediction for the LRUs. For the indigenous development, we have followed the detailed process and in the similar manner, specs, component build standard, drawings, test schedules, qualification test result, performance feedback, specification compliance, and the test schedule compliance. And finally, for the bought out item, we have released certificate for each LRU for the service induction. Now from the LRU, we have switched over to the system. The system have got the many LRUs when we have converted the complete aircraft in 17 systems. These are the systems followed for the LCA, avionics system, electrical, lighting system, cockpit control and display system, flight control system, structure, we have also made the system, aerodynamics. And now you see the power plant. These are all mechanical system, fuel system, hydraulic, landing gear, brake management system, ECS, life support system, armament, escape, and brake parachute system. Now for an example, very small example, for the mechanical system, the cluster of the mechanical system, it covers the 150 plus LRUs for the various mechanical system. We have followed very strong certification process for the mechanical system. In the system, LRU is to be certified first. The scrutiny of design analysis document for the design adequacy, test schedule formulated for its functionality, I'm talking system functionality, safety and redundancy requirement, the qualification of system in the test rig.
5 minutes.
Oh, sorry, then I have to go little. Though his journey is very long, but I'll just finish in a quick time. So this is the certificate process followed for the mechanical system. And for avionics system also 50 plus LRUs, we have followed the very strong certification process. Now come to the software. This software is known as a software, but it is a very, very robust system on the aircraft. Ladies and gentlemen, you really amazed. The 1,550 flights has undertaken on the 11 various platforms. Not a single time any software bug was noticed during the flight. Otherwise, it may become catastrophe for the aircraft. Our certification group in RCMA under the Gracie Philip, we have really given tremendous certification, a very strong certification for the software, for the 8 safety critical software and 30 mission critical software. And still it is flying very successfully. And we have followed military standard. There are 43 main standards followed for the aircraft certification associated with the hundreds of the associated military standard. For we have followed the complete compliance of the military standard. Now system certification, this is a very, very strong process we have followed, and the weekly review under the chairmanship of C. Semilek. He has made all our Saturday to work from July onwards for the 6 months, because he has given the date 27 December, the IOC should be given, and every Saturday, like we used to go to the Sunny Temple, we used to go to the ADA for the system certification review, and we thought it is a spoiled Saturday, but let me tell you, it was really gained to us tremendous confidence we have got through last 6 months. Really, it was a Sunny Temple, and we got confidence to give the IOC. This is a certificate issued for all the 17 system. And finally, when aircraft is to be inducted in the services, there is a requirement of release to service document. How this the aircraft will be operated in the services, we have made the detailed RST, release to service document, which covers various aspects during the operation and the maintenance of the aircraft in the services. Right now we have got some limitation because the envelope is restricted. It is going to be expanded in the phased manner. We have restricted certain life, some LROs, because we have not completed the qualification test, which needs a very long endurance test. Right now for the control stick, we have given 750 hours, AMAGV 300 hours, though it is qualified 1,000 hours. But because it is successfully flown on one aircraft for continuously 300 hours, we have right now restricted the life to 300 hours. Landing gear 1300 hours, airframe 250 hours. And this is the envelope going in a very progressive manner, is going to be expanded. Now, here is a very, very strong step in this whole program. The contribution of the PMT team, this is a project monitoring team, it is inducted by Indian Air Force in the program. This is headed by Air Vice Marshal and placed at ADA with a strong team of operation and maintenance officers from the Indian Air Force. The objective of this team was to interface between designer and user, and they have guided the designer towards the operational philosophy of IF squadrons, maintenance aspect of the aircraft, aircraft publication manuals required for the operation, compliance of ASR with correct interpretation of the requirement, and the compliance of the military standard vis-a-vis operational requirement. I am sure, and I make this statement, this has done very wonderful step. Involvement of the Indian Air Force team in the program at this stage, which has made our this LC induction to the services. This certificate is issued by CE Semilek for the IOC on 10th January, the certificate and the RSD document. And the future task, still task is not yet completed on the fighter aircraft, that's why it is an initial operation phase. This autopilot mode is not yet available. The pressure refueling at 35 PSI. There is some issues on tow test, which is to be resolved. Brake parachute jettison, minimum chute jettison is 40 kilometers, needs to be reduced. Guided launch of R-73, not yet available. Operation of CMDs and RWR and autonomous mode. wake penetration to be demonstrated. Autonomous start at cold weather, maybe the next winter is to be demonstrated, and all weather operation. At the conclusion, I must say LCA was a challenge not only for the designer, for certification agency also, but the concurrent approach. It has really, the challenges has been diverted to both design and the certification. That's why we have achieved the IOC on 10th January 2011. This is attributed to visionary leaders and the consistency, dedication, hard work of the generation of the Indian scientists. More challenges lie ahead for FOC, but Similac is quite confident of delivering a safe aircraft to the Indian Air Force. I would like to say, this was the infant baby, which is conceived by the ADA, Aeronautical Development Agency, but with the strong certification methodology, it has been nurtured by Similac and made a very, very perfect woman for marriage with the Indian Air Force. Now this baby is going to its in-laws' place, is going to the mother-in-law's place, and I'm sure this Indian Air Force, there is a lot of margin is available, design margin is available. They can play around with this baby in form of the woman. They can, rough handling can be done, but I am giving some caution. I'm giving a caution to the Indian Air Force, please don't mishandle it. It is only you can handle it. That is my suggestion to the Indian Air Force. With very great love and affection, we have designed and certified this safe aircraft for the Indian Air Force. With me, the RCMA aircraft at Bangalore, not only we are involved as a team, but the various other RCMAs, those who have contributed for this program, like RCMA Air Armament and RCMA Lucknow for the accessories, Korba, RCMA Nasik, and Hyderabad for avionics, the complete effort from the complete certification agency and the Similac itself, by itself, for the type approval LRUs. With that, we have come to the thanks from all complete team, not only my team, which is working at the RCMA aircraft, but the complete fraternity of my other RCMA. We have been blamed. We are tough to crack. We are very tough nut to crack. But I am telling you, we are not plain nut. We are tough to crack the coconut. Coconut is real tough. And you have to make the dedicated and concentrated effort to break it. And you will find very snow white sweet coconut with the very delicious ground coconut water, which you know how much it is important for your health. Thank you very much.
Thank you. One question, please. One question.
What is the vision for RMT certification, reliability, maintainability, and testability? Because we saw all the steps for the future, but we didn't find one.
Reliability, we cannot, predicted reliability cannot be taken as a exact data unless until you give the feedback from the services. It has to come. Let this, you have to handle this baby, I am telling you now. This woman is coming to you. Now my boss is there. Yeah.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we had a very interesting session covering four talks, one on a new UAV system, and then on the development of micro UAVs in India, and an excellent presentation on vector acoustic sensor and its possible use, and finally on the certification of Tejas. I thank all the speakers for the excellent presentation they made, and also thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity. Thanks once in a while. Good day.